This is a joke. You're teasing me, right? You're giving this to me?
Is she anybody else in here?
No. But it's... must have cost you a fortune.
Nah, I got a deal on it. They practically gave it to me.
So, put it on.
It's an emerald. It's so beautiful.
Matches your beautiful eyes.
How long ago did this guy Lindstrom bust out of Leavenworth?
10 days ago.
He's a real heavyweight, huh? Lindstrom?
Nah, he's just a big slob that likes to knock over convenience stores and then blow the dough on horse. He hasn't killed more than 8 or 10 people.
You're so different from the others. You treat me like I'm a real person.
What are you, a ghost?
No. I'm a whore.
That wasn't your fault. Your hooking days are over. No, you're with me.
Hi there. You boys look like you're ready for some female appreciation.
Ready, willing, and able to rock and roll all night.
Well, that's expensive, but group rates are available.
Mike, knock it off.
You seen this guy around?
He's been around, behind, upside down, inside out. He's been everywhere with everybody.
Where can I find him? Come on, where do we find him?
In the silver trailer.
Let's go.
Sorry, ladies, I'd like to start.
Meet you in Vegas tomorrow night?
Can't wait.
Me neither. It's gonna be... Lorella.
Who?
I gotta go.
Polly, is everything okay?
No, everything's fine. I'll meet you in Vegas tomorrow night. The Golden Lady. Huh? I have direct carpet on.
Big, huh?
About the size of a small redwood.
Disposition?
Like a pit bull after being stung by a bee. You go first. Then.
John Lindstrom, you're under arrest.
Don't move.
I'm never coming back!
Boy, Leon Varsity.
stick around. As soon as the fire's out and everything's back to normal, everybody gets a free ride. One time only.
Come on, get away from there. Come on, get away from there.
Oh, dear.
What's that, partner?
Leon Barsky, 4th Chicago Avenue, right? It's Nate. Nate Grossman.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Mike. Leon, we grew up together. You remember Leon Barsky?
Yeah, he sold me a 54 Buick.
Beautiful piece of automotive machinery.
Yeah, if I would have squeezed it, it would have come out pure lemonade.
I'm sorry to hear about that, but I got other problems right now.
Yeah, looks like you're as popular in Nevada as you were in Chicago.
I'm too popular here. That's my problem. Everybody loves me.
Your friends have a funny way of showing it.
My friends did not do this. Try Ed Sappel.
Who's that?
Rancho Chaparral. It's the top cat house in the county. Now they're trying to burn me out because they can't compete. These guys still cops.
Oh, no. Forget it.
Forget what? I got rights. This place is legal in this county.
Oh, no, my friend. We are here and we are federal to pinch an escaped felon for interstate flight. And that's it. If you got any problems, you tell the locals. Let's go.
The local cops are probably the ones who burned this place down. And where are the fire trucks?
Well, looks like you got a spot of trouble here.
Spot of trouble? That's all you know about it? You and your thugs know who did this, and you're protecting them. And I'm sick of it.
Hey, back off, you big clown. What was the Department of Justice?
What the hell are you doing in my county?
Your county? Unless Nevada seceded from the United States, it's my country.
Why are you mixing in here?
He's a friend of ours.
Savile torched my place, Nate.
Yeah? You probably did it yourself. For the insurance, for the publicity.
Where are the fire trucks, Bo?
Well, if I see those boys stop for coffee or donuts, I'll hurry them on out here.
Nate, Mike, you gotta help me.
It's not our case. It's a local beef. Let's go.
Hey, Mike.
What if Leon's got a legitimate beef? I mean, that sheriff's a gorilla.
I think he's right, I think.
Shut your mouth. Look, Nate, it's a rinky-dink whorehouse war. We are not getting involved. It is not our case. Get in the car, we're leaving.
I'm sorry, Leon.
Where's Danny and the famous hand?
Danny just called. They're on their way.
A weekend in Tahoe with a librarian. Poor guy. She probably spent the whole time in one of those flannel things that covers up everything but her ankles, reading old books, wearing funny glasses.
Danny will probably get cabin fever, listening to cello music.
She's probably a very, very nice girl.
Nice? Come on, Mike. Since when do you take a broad to a cabin in the woods to be nice? I'm sure she's got a great personality, but...
Here they are. He's got on a tie.
Hi, guys. Sorry we're late. Guys, I'd like you to meet Ann Bradford.
You are Joey. Hi. Danny didn't tell me you were so cute.
Well, he's not my type.
Walter, it's a real pleasure to meet you.
The pleasure is all mine.
And this tough-looking guy must be Mike. Danny never has a kind word to say about you.
I feel exactly the same way about him.
Where's Nathan?
Oh, yeah, he had to take a rain check. Came down with the flu or something. He's probably at home right now, curled up on a couch with a warm glass of milk or something.
Sorry to hear that.
So, how did Leon Barsky turn up in Nevada?
Burned too many bridges, saw too many deals go down. Decided to come out to the great American West. Clean air, straight talk, pleasant surroundings.
How'd you fall into these particular surroundings?
This business is a lot like selling cars. Sex appeal for a price. But now I know why Duke Curtin sold this place so cheap. Hey, Nate, you want to take a break or what? Half an hour?
Oh. Savile, he leaned on Curtin before you got here?
That's what I hear. Hassled the girls, poisoned the water. The same thing he's doing to me. And you can't go to the law, because Savile's been paying off the sheriff for years.
You got proof of that?
If I had proof, would I be talking to you?
I got no jurisdiction, Leon.
Then who keeps the local cops honest? How does a man get justice? The law says I got a right to run this place. You guys gotta help me out.
Well, I'll talk to Mike, but I don't think it's gonna do any good. Be in touch.
Say, mister. Are you going to Vegas?
That's right.
Give me a lift.
Sure thing, hop in. You done for the night?
I'm done forever.
Tomorrow night, everything's gotta be majestical. Everything's super deluxe. Champagne, caviar, and make sure you use the new tablecloths. I want the band playing. I want waiters wherever I look. So when I snap my fingers, I got service. When it's time to be alone, I don't want to see nobody. This girl is very special to me. So you make it very special for her, right?
Yes, certainly, Mr. Taglia.
Hey, that's it. Wait a minute. Don't be stingy with them after dinner minutes.
So, you from around here?
No, I'm from Salt Lake City originally.
Salt Lake, it's a long way from Vegas. It's a tough town.
I got a friend there now. That's gonna make all the difference. I'm going in early to surprise him. He gave me this ring.
That's some rock.
It's an emerald. He said it set off my green eyes.
It's a beauty. Speaking of set off, you around for that fire before?
Sure.
Anything you can tell me about it? Anything you saw?
Everybody knows it was Ed Savile.
Oh, yeah? You know him?
I used to work for him. Him and Barsky are as different as two men could be. Savile don't treat you like person. He treats you like property.
Can you believe this? Stopping me for speeding in the middle of a deserted highway?
Oh, no. This is awful.
Don't worry about it.
This is some crazy county. Takes all of you to write me a ticket?
Just shut up and show me your license.
Back off, pal. I got a federal badge, and I'm here on official business.
Nathan Grossman, you stand charged with several violations of the Nevada Penal Code. Driving while under the influence, resisting arrest, and aggravated assault. These are all serious charges. How do you plead?
Not guilty, Your Honor.
It took you so long. Shut up.
Are you Mr. Grossman's attorney?
No, Your Honor, I'm not. However, there is an assistant U.S. attorney on his way. My name is Lieutenant Michael Torello. I'm Detective Grossman's superior. We're with the Department of Justice Organized Crime Strike Force. I can vouch for Detective Grossman's character and will guarantee any further court appearances.
What the hell is going on in my courtroom?
I'm sorry for the interruption, Your Honor, but under the circumstances...
Not you. You, Mr. Ferry. Remember Luke 17? Obstacles must inevitably come. But alas, for the person who causes them, what the hell is an officer of the law doing up on these chicken slop charges in my courtroom?
Excuse me, Your Honor. The complaint was signed by three deputies.
Well, I think the deputies are lying, Your Honor.
These men swore under oath.
That's enough. If you have charges to make, Lieutenant, you should know the proper way to bring them. As for you, Mr. Ferry, I don't care if Matthew, Mark, and Luke signed this complaint. This is a law and order county, and we treat our law enforcement colleagues with respect. I hereby dismiss all charges against Detective Grossman.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you, Your Honor.
But, Detective, if you ever dishonor your badge again in my county, vengeance is mine. I will repay, saith the Lord.
It's quite a judge. We could use him in Vegas.
Shut up.
Hey, Mike. Shut up and get in the car. Mike, I'm sorry. All I did was get out of the car to show him my license. I told you, they jumped me. The sheriff's department out here is totally corrupt.
Hey, didn't I tell you that I didn't want to get involved? Didn't I give you an order not to get involved? Now we look like goofs, Nate. All of us look like goofs because of you.
What about the girl? What happened to her?
Dispatch, Deputy 2-4, over.
What girl?
Come
the
back,
hooker.
Deputy 2-4.
She'll tell you what went on down
there. No. I don't want to hear about nothing. I don't want to hear about no hooker. I don't want to hear about no girl. I don't want to hear about nothing else.
This is 2-4 requesting ambulance at junction of Highway 51 and Arroyo Lane. Victim is Caucasian, female, early 20s, blonde hair, green eyes, over.
Mike, green eyes.
Deputy 2-4,
she had green eyes.
Dispatch. We have an ambulance.
It could be her.
What's the ETA on that ambulance, over?
What happened?
How'd she die?
Look, you guys aren't even supposed to be in here.
I asked you a question.
Suicide. She threw herself under the wheels of a county vehicle.
Oh, that's crazy. This girl was happy. She was getting out of the life. She was on her way to meet someone.
What the hell are you people doing here?
What happened to Sue Ellen after your goons grabbed her?
I understand she was despondent. Took her own life.
I bet a lot of people take their own lives while they're in your custody. Or get killed resisting arrest or burn down their own businesses.
I don't need a bunch of big city feds to come in here and tell me how to enforce the law. Now you get the hell out of here.
Your county is rotten and you're a big slob. Worse than that, you're a big dummy. By you killing that girl, you're gonna have us in your ugly face. Get out of my way.
Get this thing out of here!
I wish I could tell you more about her. People in the life don't talk about the past. Not the truth, at least.
Did you know she used to work for Saville over at the Rancho Chaparral?
Nah, but she wouldn't be the first person to come over. Girl.
You think that's one reason your place might have been hit and the girl killed? Scare people off from working here.
Yeah, maybe.
What about a Johns? I mean, anybody regular, anybody special who might could tell us something about her?
Leon, what we're looking for is a way into the case, something that we can take into the U.S. Attorney's office.
Yeah, there was one guy came out from Vegas all the time, stayed a night. Short, kind of stocky, flashy clothes. I think he was from Chicago, too. He's from Chicago. Bagley, Maglia.
What are you doing standing around? Do something, huh? Look at these flowers. They're half dead. Get rid of them. And it's ice. It's all melted. Get a fresh one. What are you doing here, Torello, huh? Your timing stinks. I'm expecting somebody.
Sue Ellen's not coming, Paulie.
No.
No! No! No!
What happened?
She was murdered.
Who done it? Tell me who done it. I'll take care of it myself.
Hey, listen to me, Paulie. For the first time in your life, I'm going to handle something for you. It's important for us to know what you know.
It was that bastard, Sable. Practically kidnapped him out of Utah in the first place. Her and her girlfriend, Rita, lied to him. He told them they were going to get jobs in casinos, like waitresses or something.
Then what?
And then he locked them up in that place, their ranch. He told them they owed all this travel money. And the only way they could pay it back was on their backs. They forced her into all that. They stole all her money. So she finally ran away to Barsky. Getting her out of all that. Just getting her out of that life.
I never lied to you, Paulie. This guy violated a federal crime, the Mann Act. We're gonna bury him for it.
Barsky ain't booking. He's rebuilding.
What's it gonna take for that hustler to get the message?
We'll send him the same one we delivered to that Fed.
Lay off the heavy stuff for a while.
Fine. Only when the time comes, ain't gonna send no one around to reason with Barsky. I'm gonna do that thing myself.
Right?
Yes.
Got the gloves?
Sweater?
Oh, yes. Sunglasses?
Yes. Toothbrush?
Yes. You?
Yes.
Me?
Yes.
Log cabin.
Moonlight.
Yes.
Soft music.
Yes.
Bedtime reading.
No.
The vacation is over.
Oh, no, no.
We haven't left yet.
I'm sorry, Ann.
Come on. Be right back, baby. What?
I want you to talk to a girl named Rita.
Rita? Oh, Mike, come on. Can't you get one of the other guys, Joey?
Danny, you're the only one of us that they haven't seen. I need to put a customer inside.
Inside? Inside where?
my friend. Who do you love?
Well, a friend of mine told me about this pretty little brunette named Marita. Said she was the sweetest thing since watermelon.
Well, your friend didn't lie, but she's with someone.
Well, you change all that, right?
Excuse me, boys. Come on with me, honey. Plenty of female loveliness in the room, boys. Knock yourself out.
Paul Taglia told me about you. Said you're best friends with Sue Ellen.
We go back.
Hey, that's our whore.
Well, you better find something else or get used to waiting, because right now she's with me.
Hey, Bo, you want to wait? Me neither. So why don't you bebop on out of here, short stuff?
It's a big knife.
Yeah, and plenty sharp. Looks like you're gonna be waiting, Charlie.
Well, okay.
Who are you? What's your beef?
Name's Savile. I own this place. Tearing it up is a good way to get yourself killed. Only I got a better idea.
Hello, Mike.
Yeah, did you see the girl?
Well, yeah.
Come on, how did it go?
Well, it got a little messy.
What'd you get?
I got a job.
You didn't drive 50 miles back from Las Vegas to thank me again, did you, Lieutenant?
No, Your Honor. I came back because I think we share a mutual problem.
What problem is that?
24 hours after your county deputies took Sue Ellen Christopher away from Detective Grossman, who they beat to a pulp, she turns up dead. A suicide victim without a note and without motive. I think it stinks.
Some would say life is cheap for a girl like that.
She has the same rights, Your Honor.
You're damn right she did. Same rights as anyone else. And I'm every damn bit as mad as you. That's why I've asked the district attorney to open a full-scale investigation into the whole episode.
Thank you, Your Honor. And I'd like your authorization to place all the suspected personnel under electronic surveillance.
This county is over 15,000 square miles big. We've got less than 10,000 people. A lot of lonesome, ornery desert, and exactly the same kind of people. People who like their privacy. People who like to live their life without Big Brother looking over their shoulder. I feel the same way, always have. I will not compound any crimes that may have been committed by authorizing even more heinous ones.
Your Honor, I don't see what's so heinous about bugging a few phones.
This isn't Chicago or New York. In Bannon County, we do things a lot simpler. Mary.
Yes, sir.
Send Bo in here. Bo, the lieutenant here is concerned about the dead hooker in the desert, and so am I. It reflects badly on all of us. So I'm telling you, I want this mess cleaned up. If any of your boys were involved, or God help you, if you were involved, if the good Lord don't take care of you, I swear I'll do it myself. Now, get the hell out of here.
do that.
You work here, don't you?
Nobody hired me to beat up girls. I'm a friend of Paulie's, remember?
Why did they hit you?
Run away. Oh, I hate it here. They lied to me about this place. And every time I try to go.
Sample, you bastard!
My friend is Sue Ellen. She said she committed suicide. Just like you're gonna do.
Start cutting. Cut!
Well, I'm gonna start blowing pieces off you.
Go ahead. Pull the trigger.
Trusting you not to blow my cover. And you gotta trust us to get this bastard in the stub he works for.
Is he gone yet?
Yeah. Who was that?
Some wacko crawled out of the desert. You do good work. I guess I owe you one.
Pay up any time.
The Sheriff Bo Cray is some piece of work. Ex-LAPD and ex-Wilshire Vice bagman. He got caught dirty, got dismissed from the force.
So, where does he land after L.A.? Way out in beautiful Bannon County.
Yeah, and a big 6 months after he arrives, he gets elected sheriff in a landslide.
How did he manage that?
Not on charisma, that's for sure.
Cray must have gotten in with the right people real fast.
Yeah, but who?
Barsky has replaced the damaged trailer. He's planning some kind of big reopening ceremony.
We better send him our final message.
Me and the boys will take care of it.
No. I got a better idea.
What would you do for 10 grand?
Just about anything. Anything at all.
Then it's payback time.
Get half up front. Yeah, we'll be ready for you.
$5,000. Count it. When I hear Barsky's croaks, there's another fend coming your way.
Another $5,000. You got the piece?
Clean. Straight from the armory. Impossible to trace. You can lose it in the desert when you're done.
Mm-hmm.
Tonight. He buys it tonight. You've done this before, right?
Well, not exactly. You see, I'm a cop.
You're under arrest. Come on, open them up!
Bastard, you
shut up! Come on. Hey, throw the cuffs on this puke. Here. You got everything?
Every beautiful, bloodthirsty word.
You're in big trouble, Ed. How are you gonna squirm out of it?
You fools can go to hell. I'm telling you nothing.
Get the hell out of here. Take him into town fast. Mike wants to see him.
Yeah, what about you?
I'll catch up with you later.
Are you sure I won't have to come back? Ever?
I'm sure.
Stupid ape. You try and screw around with me, put a black mark against my name?
Uh-oh, we better get out of here.
I'm gonna make you sorry you ever laid eyes on me.
I'm already sorry!
All right, come on. Get away from me and shut up!
It's too late now.
Brutality, huh? You sign a complaint against me for brutality? You roach that likes to shoot up teenagers? What do you think, I'm stupid or helpless? You busted out of the joint 3 times. You think anybody's gonna question me when I tell them I killed you for trying to escape? Mike, take it easy.
Get away from me, I said. You're all noise. You're bluffing, Torello.
Nice, huh? You want to hear noise, tough guy?
Mike.
Huh?
Mike. Huh?
What are you doing here?
Mike, I'm sorry. We didn't know you were going to be...
What the hell is wrong with you? We saw everything.
Hey, I didn't see
that. Shut your mouth. You know what to do. Go on.
I'm telling you, this ain't necessary. I'll tell you anything you want to know, anything.
What the hell could a strunz like you tell us?
Barsky, about setting him up, torching the place.
So what? With you gone, the case is closed.
The girls, white slavery. Please, I'll give you the whole operation.
We got Rita stashed. We don't need your testimony. Gag him. Open wide.
Wait, Mike. Use this. It's from the armory. It can't be traced.
Take the gag out.
Cray, I've been paying him off.
Who take your word?
I got books, records. Please, I can prove it. Please, I swear I'm telling the truth.
Get him out of here.
Man, I almost bit my tongue off to keep from laughing. Oh. You gonna put a good word in to the warden for me?
I give you my word, didn't I?
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah. Damn.
We got a problem. Torello's got Sabo. It's only a matter of time.
To everything, there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die.
Get Sabo out here. He's got a date with the U.S. attorney.
Sabo? He's gone.
How did that happen?
Sorry, Mike. Had to do it.
His lawyer showed up with a writ of habeas corpus.
Let me see this. Order to produce the defendant, Eighth Circuit Court, signed by Judge Neville Harmon.
You were right. The Bible-quoting judge is his dirtiest sin.
Harmon is a kingmaker in Bannon County. A crooked sheriff could never get elected without his support.
The judge is running the whole racket from his courtroom.
Yeah, but this writ is going to be the mistake that buries him.
Where's Barsky?
The sheriff came for him a while ago. Took him away in cuffs. They said he killed Ed Saville.
What? What the hell is that all about?
The judge. He didn't get Saville out of jail to save him. He got him out to kill him. He'll frame Barsky for it and get rid of his problems all at the same time.
We have to get there first.
Good where first, Joey? Where's Cray?
He's not here.
Hey, we know that.
And unless you tell us where he takes all those people who commit suicide, you're not going to be around here either.
Shit in this way, don't it? A couple of pimps blow each other away at high noon. Nobody really gives a damn, do they? Of course, we'll get a little more heroic with the story. How Barsky drugged poor, well-respected Ed Saville out here, gunned him down in cold blood. How he had to chase Barsky down through this rugged terrain and how we had to do our duty. What the hell difference does it make? Still be plenty of whores to go around in Bannon County. Do it.
Somebody's coming!
Come on, hold them off.
Your friend, you try to stop me.
I told you were a big dummy. You picked the wrong guy for a hostage.
What?
Saville's the guy we need for a case against the judge. Barsky is expendable.
You're bluffing.
Walter?
Yeah.
Danny?
Clear shot.
Joey?
Uh-huh.
You know, when we got here, Cray, there were five of us.
Tim and Nate, I didn't know you were that good a shot.
Tell you the truth, I'm not.
Nor will this court go along with the rising tide of permissiveness that is sweeping the rest of the nation. Ye have plowed wickedness, ye have reaped iniquity. Therefore, I have little choice but to impose on you the maximum penalty the law allows. I sentence you to... Lieutenant, what do you think you're doing? Bailiff.
Yes, Your Honor.
I remind you, court is in session, my court.
This is not your court or your county anymore, Your Honor. You're under arrest.
You impudent.
Save it, Your Honor.
And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. Isaiah 13, 11.
Oh, yeah, your soul is going to jail. Torello, 1963.
Let's go.
Is Anna Tahoe all by herself?
I hope so. She makes friends easily.
Ah, come on, you two got a great thing going. One little deal like this isn't gonna wreck it.
No, it's not that. It's just the life. I mean, who can put up with it? Where do you find him?
You're asking me that question? You got the wrong guy, pal. Hello, Polly. Never Polly? Seen you here before.
Never been here before. I don't go to cop bars. They're dumps.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I read that you made that pinch out in the desert.
I was judge, sheriff.
Made for some pretty big headlines, huh?
Don't forget Savile.
Never forget Savile. I'd like to buy you a drink.
You gonna join us?
Yeah. Just this once. But don't get no ideas.
Angie.